here we are at Fateh Darwaza. This is the place where Aurangazeb's army was camped out during the siege. And this is also where the siege ended, when they bribed one of the generals to open the gate from here and allow the army inside and to conquer the Golkonda fort.
The history of Hyderabad is about 500 years old, starting from Golkonda. And Hyderabad as a city has evolved over these 500 years as a result of many communities contributing in many ways.
So here you see this cannon which is here. These were all cast on the site and mounted on the ramparts.
So the legacy of Hyderabad is actually reflective of what communities did in terms of their built architecture, their trade, commerce, the art and handicrafts. Everything is reflective of the people of Hyderabad. What we are trying to do is to re-envision how these places come alive, whether as tourist destinations, whether as community welfare centers, or as places of interest and education. There are basics that we need to work on in terms of protecting the place, clearing out encroachments, maintaining the place, making sure that there's no garbage around these sites. Each site should have some kind of a visitor center where the history of Hyderabad is disseminated through books and pamphlets and maps.
When I came to know about this meeting today, we are going to assemble here. So I was very excited and I wanted to come here and explore more.
We are touching history when we sit here. And this is essentially who we are, our culture. This is a treasure for Hyderabad.
Very few people know about the details and the background, the history of this place. So I think it's a very good initiative and it should continue. We all should contribute.
I hope people bring their families here instead of maybe also doing the malls, but this is a place, a part of who you are. So it's very important for you to come and bring your children here.
The tourism industry will come alive only when we curate experiences to which people can relate, whether it's exhibitions or poetry sessions or Meena bazaars or talks from historians. As you can see, the Fateh Darwaza is not really on the map where tourism is taking place actively. Most people just go into the main fort, but it's one of the most impressive bastions of the fort's outer walls, and the potential it holds is enormous.
One of the most exciting parts of Golkonda, because this actually represents the end of the Qutub Shahi Empire when they were conquered by the Mughals.
Our endeavor is to basically bring places like this alive.
We didn't think about any door on top of the city, it connects with the city.
How can we, you know, learn from our rich past, and how can we rethink about our current urbanism? I think that becomes a bit important for architects and in general for the general public.
Interesting to see ki kis tarah se yahan pe existing kis tarah se logon ne associate kiya yahan pe is monument ko, kyunki unke liye heritage bhi nahi hai, unke liye kafi badhkar hai, ek alag hi cheez jo hum shayad nahi samajh payenge. I think us tak pahunchne us wo jo samajh rahe us association aur hamara jo association as in heritage, unke beech ka kahin hame solution iske liye dhoondna padega.